What is up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Kreepers and I'm here today with another video of Paladins. And in today's video, I am actually talking again about the new information, you know, the new teasers coming to the realm, to the game, to the next event, probably this next patch coming out. So the first thing that we saw was a book with a symbol and the Eternal Pyre title, not to mention that necklace with a shield kind of formation. And then we also saw the city Ceres, which had the symbols of the magistrate. This is the city that it was connected to the Auror champion called Ceres, which through the lore we get to know that she destroys this city somehow. She was an oracle, you know, just wandering around in the abyss. And what happened was she somehow came into our world, and then this was the first place where she got to destroy. Now, here's the thing. We already knew that somehow the Ceres, you know, it was already connected to the magistrate. But then they decided to put this picture today. This picture was actually posted 30 minutes ago. And what it says on top, it says, "Extreme measures must sometimes be taken to protect all citizens of the realm from potential threats. The magistrates thanks you for your understanding and sacrifice." Here's the thing. If you take a look to the picture, what it says is, "Attention, the abyss hungers. You have been chosen. Your sacrifice keeps the realm safe." Pretty much what they're doing here is they're forcing somebody to become a sacrifice. This person pretty much is gonna die, because what I can understand from this is, if you do know a little bit of the story of Ceres, she is gonna consume the soul of whoever was just sacrificed. This person was handpicked, and whoever it is, it has to do it. It may be like force. Remember seeing a little part of the video where the magistrate was forcing people to do what they wanted? Well, pretty much this is a good example. If I technically don't know how is the magistrate connected to why is the abyss hungers, you know, the abyss, they're probably talking about maybe Ceres. What I'm also have like a different theory. What I think about all of this is that, imagine somehow our new champion, right, the champion coming, the new support coming, was actually messing around with forces, and it actually, you know, did something wrong. What happens is they probably just opened the portal to the abyss, you know, you know what abyss is, and the abyss is like somehow trying to get in there, but if you give them souls, it shrinks, you know, the portal tries to shrink. And maybe this is what happened. Everybody on this city just, you know, just got feeded to this portal, this abyss, or whatever it was. And in the end, we get to see Ceres appearing, right? Everybody was sacrificed. Everybody was dead from this city. The entire city was destroyed when it comes to, you know, lives. And Ceres came into the realm. This is pretty much connected to the lore that we've been thinking so far. But now this also means that the magistrate either was just trying to bargain with Ceres. Maybe she was not a portal, she was actually a physical form already. They were just trying to give her soul so she would stay on their side, or just trying to control her, but giving her souls would make her a lot stronger. I'm not entirely sure at this moment. This is becoming a little bit confusing, because we definitely know that Ceres is connected, because the Abyss, the Oracle of the Abyss, is Ceres. And Ceres has been known for by destroying the city Ceres, which we have seen in the picture, and we've seen a book that it may belong to a mage, which may be our support. We know all of these things, but in what situation are people being sacrificed? You know, they're being forced to become sacrifices, human sacrifices, in order to keep the realm safe. I still don't get it. I still don't know. The magistrate is pretty much taking a role here which looks really bad. I don't know if they're really trying to just save everything and they really need to do the sacrifices in order for example, Ceres would not become like a huge monster or something else. I've also thought that it could also be related to her weapon. In case you never noticed, her weapon, when you use the ultimate, she throws the orb, right? The orb that she holds on the weapon, and everybody is pulled to it, like pretty much like a dark hole, pulling the souls, pulling the people, whatever it is. I thought that maybe whatever it was, the entity that came from the abyss, was actually that little orb. And after they started feeding the orb to see if it was strong enough, maybe somebody became, you know, a vessel for the orb, and this is the character that we get to see, which is Ceres, and somehow they were just trying to feed it to see if they could, you know, just use it, or maybe just not to explode, or maybe it was because it was trying to kill some other people that they didn't want it, so they were just giving them food, in this case people, so they would somehow have it under control. I'm not entirely sure, or trying to bargain with it. It could mean a lot of things. We know that this is connected to Ceres, that's for sure. And we also know that somehow it's connected to our new support. It may not, I mean, we were saying this for a very long time, but is it truly 100% sure that this is actually connected to our support? The only thing that leads me to think that it's connected to our new support is the book. Because the book has to be something related with somebody that has the power of fire. And the Dynamine said that this new champion actually has a power that can go through walls, and actually is related to a blast. So pretty much like a mini ult, you know, if you ever seen Genos ult can go through walls, right? You can literally shoot through walls. So a lot of times you use this ult from a very far away, but just try to put it in a line that passes through the point, and so you can push people out of the point. And maybe her blast somehow has a limited range, but it can do almost the same. I don't know. But the thing is, that's the only thing that tells me that that's actually a new champion coming out, and that is the support that we've been talking about. I mean, definitely has to be support, because they said that the next champion coming out is definitely indeed a support, so it had to be her in this case. So she could either be an angel, she could either be a mage of fire, she could be a lot of things. Okay, I even thought, I already have a theory as well, that on Realm Royale, the game, there's also a class that it's called Mage. I still am trying to believe that class that hasn't been entered, that hasn't entered the game, is not somehow connected to this, but it may be. They may be waiting for Paladins to release this new champion so they could put her weapon or whatever is in the game. I don't know. I mean, if that was true, the last class that they are also going to be putting, which is the Hunter, should have been there already, because believe me or not, I think that class is going to have the Xiaoling bow. And for those who don't know what game I'm talking about, it's the Battlegrounds that you used to know, but instead of having champions, we now have like standard characters, but just with some three classes at the moment, and you get to play. It's a battle royale game still, about almost 100 people, you get in a map, there's a fog closing in until the middle, last person alive wins. So that's pretty much it. For those who don't know Realm Royale, you should also go check it out. I have a ton of videos right now at the moment, and been doing a lot of streams of it. And I've also been doing some videos about these new teasers. This teaser, for example, I'm still trying to understand completely what it means. There's not a lot of information. And I gotta be honest, I like this. Because, believe it or not, I actually complained a few time ago that Hyrus wasn't doing, you know, Easter eggs or keeping things secret enough or even just teasing us enough. But now they have been starting it, doing a little bit, at least since Moji. And I think it's awesome. The lore, the videos, everything. Even the artwork is different, you know, I like it. But yeah, that's basically it for the video today, guys. I just wanted to bring this new information to you guys and also let you guys think and know what I think. And I also want to know what you guys think. So go down in the comments and tell me your theories. Tell me what you think about this, okay? What do you think that this may mean? How is Ceres connected to somehow people being sacrificed? The idea that I had about Ceres was that she just got out through a portal and immediately used her power and started killing everybody or just destroyed the city. But then we get to see the city, which is completely unharmed, but probably without people, which from the last picture, though they released it, is saying that it's hiding an evil thing. So pretty much in that picture, I believe that everybody is like hiding in the houses, and then the magistrate just comes there and chooses some people to feed the beast, in this case Ceres. And also just one little last thing, unfortunately I don't have any recordings of this, and I'm not going to use anybody else's recordings because I don't want to raise any problems here, but I believe that the map, that it is an Onslaught map, which they already noticed, that they already said that about that, right? Just letting you guys know. The map is maybe possible to be the map that was on the beta not the beta, the testing maps. Okay, that was a feature a long time ago where there was maps, you can test them. They had no, they had no testers, and you could test the maps there. And I believe that the map that is actually connected to this is the map named Toxic. It was like a church, and pretty much there was two holes in the middle that would be opening and closing like pits, and you could just throw people in there, or if people went in there, they would die. And I know that this was still available when Leon was there, because I saw some gameplay where Leon was already there. So I don't have the gameplay. I didn't play it myself. I've seen a lot of maps of these testing maps, and this is the only one that I can relate to this new Onslaught map. So it may be, it may not be. Let's see. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Okay, I hope you guys just had some crazy new information just coming out through my video here. Although, of course, these are all theories related to the pictures that was released to us, for us to think. And pretty much that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'll see you guys next time. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye, guys.